Good evening, my wonderful kids. I hope you are with your spirits high. So, as decided, today we are going to learn a word of a day and then the first alphabet of English in cursive. So, the word is boon. What does it mean? A thing that is very helpful and that you are grateful for. So, what does it mean in Hindi? Vardaan. Okay, and now just look at, there are two ways in which we can write our alphabet A, capital A, in cursive. So, hope it will be, you will all start practicing this way. Tomorrow we will go with another words and another alphabet. Students, today we are going to talk about the most hardworking class in our society. Who are they? Any guess? Yes, of course, the farmer. See, they are working so hard. We have seen how hardworking they are. And we, what do we do exactly? We waste the food. But now, I hope, not hope, I'm sure about, once after going to the story which we are going to learn today, definitely, my students will never ever waste the food and they will really respect the class that is farmer. Students, this is a story that is January night. So, this is a very popular story. It is written by Prem Chand, one of the greatest writers in Indian literature. So, I hope your parents too must have gone through this story. The story is in Hindi also and the name of the story is Poos Ki Raat. So, this Poos Ki Raat or the January night is a story about the pitiable condition of the Indian farmer. In the story, we will see how pathetic the condition in which the Indian farmers are living. You must have seen in the TV also, many of the farmers commit suicide due to the poverty or debt they are. So, we will see how pathetic, pitiable the conditions of the farmer are. How they are suppressed by the rich landlord or the zamindar. So, one thing I can ask you, even your parents, to show you the movies related to this topic in which you can easily understand the condition of the farmer. So, some of the movies which I would suggest is Mother India, which is definitely a very old movie, and Lagan. So, many of you must have seen Lagan. So, we have seen that the farmers, because they are very poor, they need to take the money as a debt from the rich landlord or the zamindar, and the zamindar, they were suppressing the feeble class, that is the farmer. The farmer were suffering because of the two causes. First of all, they were very poor. They don't have money to afford the capitals that is needed for their farming. And secondly, the illiteracy. They were taking the money, but they don't know the tax which they were paying, or they don't know the difference between the principal amount and the simple interest. So, let us start the story. As we have seen, the title of the story is January Night. So, the story will be basically about a night spent by a farmer in the month of January outside in the field. So, let us talk about some of the characters in the story first. The main character of the story is Halku and his wife, that is Munni, and his dog, his pet dog, the name of the dog is Jabra. So, the story goes around these three characters only. So, now let's start and please do try to understand the story. Halku came in and said to his wife, "The landlord's come. Get the rupees you set aside. I will give him the money and somehow or other we will go along without it. So the first scene starts that Halku came to his wife and asked her to give the money. Why? To pay to the landlord. Landlord means, as already told, zamindar. And they told that they will give the money and so that they would be little relieved. Munni had been sweeping. She turned around and said, but there are only 3 rupees. If you give them to him, where's the blanket going to come from? How are you going to get through this January night in the fields? So what that Munni was doing that time? She was sweeping or cleaning the house. And randomly when Halku asked for the money, she said that there was only 3 rupees which they kept aside for buying a blanket. So if that money was given, how could Halku buy a blanket to survive during the January night in the field? Tell him, we'll pay him after the harvest, not right now. So Munni asked Halku to say to the landlord that they will pay him after the harvest. After the harvest means cutting of the crops, not right now. For a moment Halku stood hesitating. Without a blanket, it couldn't possibly sleep in the field at night. So hesitating means slow in acting. Halku thought for a moment when Munni said that how could they survive in the cold winter and ask a landlord to pay after harvest. Halku thought for a moment and definitely it will not be possible to survive in the cold winter night during the month of January. So you can easily relate to this people. During the January month or December month, we are not wearing, we can say we are overloaded with the warm or woolen clothes. So can we think of surviving during the night without a blanket? Definitely no. But the landlord wouldn't be put off. He would threaten and insult him. But there is another situation before Halku. The landlord who was standing outside to take the money will definitely be very angry and will insult Halku on not receiving the money. So Halku, we can see, is in a situation of confusion or he is puzzled. On one hand, he need a blanket to survive during the winter season, and another, he also want to avoid the insult which landlord would do on not receiving the money. So what did it matter if they died in the cold weather, as long as they could just take care of this calamity right now? People, just think how pathetic, how pitiable, how sad the situation says about the condition of the farmer. Halku is ready to die out of cold, but he is not ready to bear the insult of the landlord. So he decided that it will be better to give money rather than to bear the insult of Halku, by landlord. As he thought this, he moved his heavy body that gave the light to his name. So as he thought, he moved his heavy body. So here we can say that Halku, the mean Halku means Halka. Halka means what? Lightweighted. So here, but we see a farmer who is little bulgy or bulky, we can say, who is little fat. So this situation, he tried to walk, moved his heavy body. So here he was trying to move slowly. So here this mean, and came close to his wife. And see, why slowly people? We can, at the time when we are in confusion, when we are cannot decide, so what do we do? Can we walk slowly, fastly? No, Definitely, that is why Halku was walking slowly, thinking what will be good for him right now, and then deciding that it will be better to give the money to the landlord. He came to his wife. So today, up till here only we will continue. So please do as instructed, and tomorrow again we will continue further. Good night, dear students.